Hello and welcome to the 2019 Halloween Howler Final Skins. This is your host, P-Tata. Go ahead, before we start this video, smash that subscribe button. That way you can keep up to date with all the new P-Tata films. We're going to get right into it here. You have your top four competitors at the Halloween Howler. Mr. Cameron Coglazer, who won it. You have Maddie O in second place. Kyle Kurt in third, and JC Rowe coming in fourth. All right, their partners are, as you'll see, Paul Gray was with Cameron. You have Andrew Cody, who is with Mr. Matthew Orr, Matty O. And then you'll see we have a few more competitors that will be showing up here in just a second. All right, Josh Hollingsworth, who got partnered up with Kyle Kurt. Tomahawk Geek King over here. Alright, and this is Kyle Kurt. So what they're doing is they're playing a safari skin for $50, $100 a hole, six holes. Each one of these competitors got $50 just for making it into the skins. Top four got in, and the other was done by a raffle to get partnered up with these top four competitors. As you see JC Rowe slinging it off to the right there. All right, now the what they're doing first is playing from hole 10, the original Chickasaw, to hole 11. So this is a double hole. All right, you got Cameron and John over there laying up just to get to the open shot in the fairway.
Get up.
As you're watching Mr. Cole swing a little hook shot on the ground, get a nice little skip. Yeah. All right, and so these players are playing to the top of the hill.
Yeah, good carry.
Looks like there's only one team right now that has a chance to get a three. Everybody else is going to have to lay out to the middle here, as you see Matty O trying to throw a forehand roller. All right, these are your two competitors here, Kyle and Josh. We have the only chance for a three. Let's see what they can do.
Oh,
Josh is really trying to get at that. He got most of the way up the fairway. At that point, they're just going to have to throw it in as these competitors try to get up there and save a four. Cameron Coglazer taking the way wide route.
Yes, sir.
Andrew Cody looking to put up a nice little shot there. Oh, get that last.
Good shot, Andrew.
Sure, Matty O can help him out.
Yeah, Matt.
Partner.
All right, as he does. All right, Kyle Kurt going for the long jumper. Big head Josh getting in the way there. All right, can you do it? Oh, not this time. Looks like they'll have to have a good chance at four there. As JC Rowe putts for a four. Caged.
Nice.
All right, now we'll see some lovely tap-ins here. There's a four. There's a four. This hole pushes to the next. Next hole, these competitors
heads
are
up.
Throwing from hole 12 original out to the open field and across the water to one of the tip holes. As you see Matty O bang a big roller out there. He'll be in a nice position.
There you go.
Okay, Kyle Kurt getting a nice little pop. And he gets out of the way.
Nice shot.
Oh, Holly Hood. Oh, not this time. All right, we got another little tree kick there. Can his partner get out? I do believe so, sir. He'll be out in the open. JC Rowe putting a nice clean shot out. Paul Gray.
There it is.
Now they are throwing from their fill shot across the lake here. as you see one come up short. JC Rowe. Splash down. Oscar Bravo. He'll still have a chance to get a four though. Alright. Josh going with the big tomahawk here. That's one shot that's hard to keep up with. But he gets it high enough, you can follow it. He'll have a chance for a three. As you see Kyle Kirk trying to lay one out. Gets a big skip off the roof. And he'll still have a chance for a three. Matteo. And he takes it in a splash. Alright, I do believe I missed his partner, but he was safe. As you see, Grego OB. Cameron. In the way there, he made it through the trees.
There's a goose that landed like right here.
What are you doing, sir? The Loch Ness Monster. All right, and he'll lay up. Get it. They'll probably get a four there.
I'm already fucking dead.
You see JC Rowe going to spike. No, sir. All right, what can Cody do? He lays it up. Smart play. Give Matteo the chance. Almost. Alright, can you get the three? Oh, so close. He gives it a great bid, but the moon got in the way. As you see Paul Gray and Cameron here in a terrible spot. There's enough to lay out and also get a four. This hole will push. And we'll move on to the next hole. Alright. As you can see, this is a tight tunnel shot, roughly 400 feet distance. We're looking at maybe two car lengths wide. Not very much room to work with, so they're going to have to navigate up the center of the fairway. Some are going to try the left gap, which is really hard, and then you'll try the right gap, which is not much easier. Okay, JC Rowe. Gets a nice shot. He'll be within the circle. It's a nice shot there. Paul Gray. A tree. Kaboom. Knocked down. No, sir, not today. Alright, that's the left gap I was talking about, but I mean, I didn't see that gap there. Alright, looks like Matteo's got a good flight on this disc.
It's coming in good.
And he'll be roughly around 40 feet. That was with Josh. Actually, that was Kyle with the tomahawk. Missed Josh's. Okay, I missed Matteo's putt, but he did miss it. This is Cole.
Oh, man.
He wanted to get that one for his partner. Let's see if JC Rowe can take three skins on this hole. Boom.
Sun coming right at it.
All right, so him and his partner split 150 right there. They're moving to the next hole through the Pumpkin Mando. This is a, however if you want to, quadruple Mando. You have to go through a square. They're playing out to the open field. Back to another temp hole. The trick of this hole is just to get past the Mando out into the field anywhere. From there you'll have hyzer either way, right or left, to the basket. The farther you get out, the easier that upshot will be. But it's pretty much routine for all these guys. As you see, a few people hitting some trees on the way out. Matty-O.
Oh, no trees.
What trees? Matty-O don't hit trees. Right? More trees? I should have a tree counter on this hole. Ever seen this guy play? Just watch out, don't get in the way of his tomahawks on his forehand. You're credit. Alright, now for some routine upshots here. Andrew Cody puts a decent one out there. He'll have a chance to putt. Can Hound Dog Boom do it? Yes, sir. Right there. Alright, you can put all the pressure on the other teams to get close to the basket. And you see Cole making his way down the fairway. Appears to have sawed it off just a little bit. They'll have a putt at it. Chase Rowe needs to get close so they don't have to sweat a putt. But they just got three skins, so that's probably still fresh on their brain. Gonna need to get close. What'd you expect? Back in? No, sir. Tomahawk. On circle's edge. Alright. Cameron and his partner shouldn't have much left here. As you see, all gray sawed off just a little bit. The sun is right in their eyes, so. Huge, crucial part of that. And no sweat for Cameron. This is for their fourth. Pretty sure this hole's gonna push. So that putt didn't matter anyway.
That's a three.
Paul Gray for three.
Perfect background music.
All right, that hole pushes off to the next hole. Boogie is playing from, I believe, OG 13's T-pad, or 13 and now's T-pad, to that basket across the lake that they played two holes or three holes ago. So they want this hole set up to make the players try and go for it. It's just on that peak distance where you can get it if it was wide open, but with that little pond being there, makes it a little more difficult. Alright, we're looking to see Matty-O and Cam put something on this hole. On the OB, but his partner, they should be able to get an easy three from where they're at. Alright, let's see what Matty-O's got. OB didn't think he was going to lay up. Alright, well, he's put a move on it. They'll have a decent look at it, but they'll be behind the bush. Kyle seems to like this roof over here. He's going for it again. This time he has found himself in bounds. Yes. He's shot at the basket.
The one hurt?
Oh, Lord.
Damn, that's what's up.
Wow. Even watching it is ridiculous to watch. Oh, man, that can do kaboom. Woo! JC trying to throw it in. Steady throws it through. I was shaking my head and I was like, oh no. Paul's gonna lay it up so his partner can run at it.
Oh my god, so deep!
I got a so deep over here too!
Oh! So deep!
bid. Seemed to have wanted it. So does Kyle. They knew how big that pot was going to be.
Heads up.
Hole in the tip course. Surrounded by these awesome signs. Say Halloween, Halloween all the way around them. Hay bales and pumpkins. Close hole at the right of the tournament.
Woohoo!
Alright, as you see these gentlemen try to put a boom on it out there.
What's up, everybody?
They're still probably about 500, 600 out.
Heads up, heads up.
Stays out of bounds, so they'll have to take it from their partner's side. So this opens the door for Cameron. All he's got to do is put a move on it for a chance for maybe like 70-foot putt, 80-foot putt. But looks like he's more around 90 to 100. He'll still have a chance at it. That'll be for their three. Okay, this is close. This is second. Into the circle. None of this is out of bounds. The circle, the island is there now just for cosmetics. JC comes up a little short, hits the sides. They'll be taking it from Coles. Okay, this will be Matteo 4-3. Josh landed on his upshot. And that was for their three. both had a chance for it. Okay, this will be Matteo. Start the push at 4. Nice putt there. Pressure on everybody else to make their push. To the next hole. I'm sorry. They all split the remaining amount. So each